Woo, here we go again. It's live. Facebook Live. That's right. Latest technology bringing connections to you. Interpersonal connections. Like the TP.
Hi, guys.
Here's the TP and...
Just ignore him. So I watched Doctor Who almost all weekend. Doctor Who Takeover. And then I missed the debut of the new season of Doctor Who. And I'm the geek. Right? I have no knack.
You are the geek.
Hi, guys. Hey, Allie. How you doing? Hope you had a happy Easter, everybody. As you can see in the back, there's porn star Pete hiding. Hey, Donna Wilson.
I think you should come up here, Pete. Come on, man.
Mm-hmm. I'm going live.
Tell your people how much you love them. Or whatever you want to say.
I'm going to get a little personal right now. I really love you guys. I got a little tear in my eye right now. Feeling emotional. It's nice to have you guys here.
Oh,
be part of connections.
Sorry about that.
Hi, Donna. Hi, Allie. Hi, everyone else. All right, we're going to talk about well-rounded children today.
That means ones that have a little bit of weight on them and how to get rid of the extra weight.
Yeah, right, gut. Because you want them to be... But you actually want your kids to be well-rounded.
You never saw such
you want them to be
chubby
smart.
Children.
You know?
Can you do like a little segment
so,
on that?
When they're 18, push them out the door and they'll be successful instead of, you know, little a-holes. We don't want them to be a-holes.
We could even incorporate it in tonight or
hey,
something.
Hey, look, I just joined.
45 seconds till the soft open, my friends.
Soft open.
Because it disturbed me. I was at church.
Yeah.
And they, like 30% of the kids were overweight or something. It was a lot for little kids.
A lot.
Man, I mean, you never saw heavy little kids. Like one in 100, maybe.
Excellence isn't that.
Are you ready? Come on, guys. Give it to me.
All right, I'll touch
you. Give me the hands. Touch me! Touch me!
Touch me like you're never.
I love radio, and I love doing broadcasting, and I love doing broadcasting with these people, so that makes me a happy man. I'm putting it out there. Facebook! Happy man, Al Spry.
Oh, here it comes. Comes the soft open, everybody. Oh, look at that clock. It's 2 minutes off.
I think she needs a vacation.
Oh my God, she has so lost it.
That must be the 12-inch version. That was awesome, man. It was quite a wave.
Yeah, it was pretty fun.
Welcome to GabNet, GabNet Live, every Monday night on GabNet. Thank you, Alex Bennett. Also want to thank our friends over at 104.1. Real Radio in Orlando, back every night. It's a beautiful thing, and we're really happy to be a part of that. That's coming up in just a couple minutes. But guys, I have to tell you something.
Yeah.
I'm very pleased about one thing. And that is that I get to do radio with you guys every night. It makes me very pleased.
Oh, stop kissing our asses.
No, I have to. I have to. Plus, porn star Pete, you're looking. You have a smoldering sensuality. I can't really. I think the women out. I think the women watching you now on Facebook Live are actually starting to turn their coat. Their toes are curling in a little bit, man.
Yeah, I do tend to grow on people. I don't know why. Something about me, I guess.
You have a certain warmth. I don't know what it is, man.
I think it's the curl in his hair today.
Limp Bizkit.
Oh, it's curling.
Yeah.
Love it.
Nice.
Golly.
Haven't heard those guys in a while. We're talking about how to raise your kids. How to rear them. Rear your kids.
My way the highway. That's what my dad used to say. I know, right?
Yeah,
remember that?
That's an old parent one. The my way or the highway. Or I pay the bills here.
That and driving down the highway and saying, don't freak me, come back there. So I always wanted to see, just once.
What, if they would actually come back there?
Yeah, from the front seat while driving. You'd always get that hand. You know,
he would have pulled over though and then whooped your butt.
Probably so, yeah.
We always knew it was curtains because my dad would stick out his tongue to one side.
Uh-oh.
In anger.
kind of. Yeah. He's holding, literally holding his tongue.
Yeah.
Like the tongue went sideways.
Yeah.
Like that was it.
Came off and went sideways, and you're like, oh, yeah, he's got me.
Got to thank Linda Nunez and Nunez Productions for the wonderful soft opening.
That thing was. That thing was over the top, man. I loved it.
There you sit, man. It'll be coming around again in about an hour. So we do have a good show for you, as always. We've got John Franks, local artist, coming in. We've got some, what do we call it? Juicy bits.
Juicy bits.
Little juicy items and bits for you to chew on tonight. And some of it looks pretty interesting, too, I might say. As I said, our local segment with John Frank, who's got a lot of stuff coming up and slated for us. He is very good.
Yes.
And the traits of a well-rounded child, porn star Pete, is here with us, as you said, and he is a daddy.
Yes, I have a 9-year-old son, and I have seen the best of both worlds from him.
Did your voices drop half an octave, man?
Yes. I just went lower.
I had no idea I could even reach that level. Porn star Pete's very relaxed, and that means... We're going to have a great radio show.
Great.
Welcome. Welcome. It's Connections.
All right.
I am a goofball.
Do you know someone who has a...
I just want to be a woman.
...drug addiction.
Yep, that's the goal. That's our ambition.
There's the goal.
We're there. I mean, we're there. We, you know, all you gotta do is just grow the show now. We got the brand. We got the show. We got the
covering addiction specialist now.
I forgot to rub the electron.
I usually rub Buddha, but it's way back. Yeah.
Everything that we predicted would happen with this show came true. It just took a little longer than you always wanted. But everything has always fallen into place. It's like Tom Benson told me, you keep doing it as long as you're getting green lights. We're still getting green lights, so we're still doing it.
Confidential call.
That's like the important thing to remember.
Before someone dies.
Before someone dies.
Fucking so dramatic.
What's that other one they do that's real dramatic? What's that other one?
That's like the hand.
Oh,
everybody dies.
So big. What
do you got there anyway? Is that jerky or something? Or
Dish has the nation's lowest TV price, along with an award-winning DVR.
So I walk into the studio and we have
thousands of movies at your fingertips.
Candy sitting at my desk. I'm trying to watch my girlish figure. And I think they know it. So before I came in here, I think they planted these on me. So,
oh God, my head's getting cut off.
What to do.
I know people don't normally want to see that.
I rah rah, hi Pook. So yeah, now I'm surrounded by chocolate the whole show. And I'm really trying to hold out on not eating them. We're going to see how that goes. Start calling me Andrew. Oh, Lizzie left it for me. Damn her. This is my weakness. It's my kryptonite. Lizzie found it. Hi, Rachel. Hey, Poop. I'll save it. I'll save it for you, Chris.
Okay.
It's Connections.
Connections is
relationship
radio.
I'm
just
going
to
keep this over by me.
Ready to start? Let's do this.
Let's do it. Mm-hmm. Connections, Monday nights.
What happened to the story?
I'm feeling all right.
Do the story.
All right, I'll do the story. You know, I never had kids, but I really, really like them, and I really like when they're well-behaved. I guess I've kind of become the uncle now because I go see a couple of my friends' kids in Tampa and I've known her for about 23 years. And the kids are teenagers now. But it's great because you can kind of have fun with them, you throw them around. You can't really throw them around anymore, they're starting to get big. But, you know, ride around and play with them. And then the end of the day, you're exhausted and you can go, here you go.
Thank you.
Thanks. Yeah. Thanks so much.
Bye.
Welcome to the show. It's Connections. So great to have a couple fun people here. Of course, the wonderful Melissa Fox and porn star Pete. We have John Frank. He's a musician, local guy here. He's going to be playing some tunes for us live. We love to do that whenever we can on a Monday night. Also talking about how to raise that well-rounded child. Now, I'm not talking about if the kid is round, that's different. But someone that's well-balanced, a good kid, so to speak.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a little later. Yeah. Would be a good adult.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be nice. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's hard. It is very hard. But, I mean, every parent wants to raise a healthy and happy kid. But so many times when they get arrested, then the parents on the news always say, "He's a good boy. I don't know." Well, I'll tell you, a kid grows. Pressures excel, you know, the whole thing. You want to be good. You want your kid to be great. You want to push all of your ideas and all of your, you know, broken down dreams on your kids. Don't do it.
No.
You want to make your kid feel confident and competent. And they need a sense of passion and purpose. And it's very hard nowadays to do that. I don't know if you've noticed, but the kids now, in the last two generations, don't seem to be, they don't seem to value anything.
No. And I think a lot of it is, you know, kind of blamed on technology.
Oh, I would.
They're stuck behind their games and they're getting spoiled. There's no outside time anymore.
Mm. But are you scared to put your kid outside now? I mean, you know, you can't just run the neighborhood like we used to. And
he can't. He actually, I mean, we take him to his grandmother's house, mm-hmm. and it's more of a playing field there. There's more kids mm-hmm. there, less cars. On my block, it don't go that way. Yeah. So you got to watch him, you know, at every step. Still at 9 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Still have to watch him very, very close.
Oh, sure.
I guess, though, there's certain parts in the country where they are still letting the kids out. Do you think that maybe out west and, you know, it's a little more rugged maybe? Maybe it's
what,
a little
you think
less...
it's frontier out there? So
like, well, I'm talking about the...
They all
still
circle
frontier
their
stuff.
Wagons is what they do.
No, right? No, but I mean...
And the kids mingle with the Indians, the Native Americans.
I'm talking about out in Montana.
They
rope, you know,
steer and what?
Yeah, exactly.
No. Hunt for bison.
You're from Wisconsin. Is this guy totally off the whack or what?
It was, yeah. And even in my generation, it was, you know, and I always tell my wife this, it's kind of like, it was like a battlefield. You know, you'd walk around there and it was constantly, you know, am I going to
get... Well, you were lucky because you look kind of Mexican.
Yeah, well, see, and I lived in a Mexican neighborhood to start, so I was fine, you know, because they all thought, you know, we'd go after my brother because he was blonde hair.
Yeah, what about the red? The ginger boy, too.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's when we'd go after.
You just kind of fit right in.
Yeah. So I camouflage right through that.
I don't know
where
that gringo is, man.
But, you know, it's survival of the fittest, and at that time I was so small that the way I could survive is, you know, camouflage.
You know, I get your point about technology porn star people. What about the influence of the parents themselves? Are they not as trained in the child rearing as much as they used to be? Is there not that? Because you used to have multiple generations of people living together, mm-hmm. and grandma got to teach mom something as mom was raising the kids and help out. You're not seeing as much of that, right?
No, what I noticed is, you know, when Caitlin was going to this particular school, we were very active parents. Not only, you know, the father, but the mother, both of us. And what we noticed is a lot of these children had, you know, one parent that could hardly come in because they were working. And also, many of them didn't speak the same language as the people that were teaching their kids. So there was a lot of barriers that was happening. So a lot of things were getting, you know, grades that could be fixed that weren't. You could see how the education and the way people handle those children deplete. Just, you know, simply not being able to have a conversation.
Well, a lot of times the kids are translators too. So on, as they say, lost in translation. Can you imagine if the teacher is telling the kid to tell his parents that, you know, like, you're not really performing well. You think that's going to come across in the old translation in Spanish from mommy or dad?
Right.
No. He says, it's very good. No. But you're right. There is a language situation, the single parenting. A lot of times, it used to be it was latchkey kids, you know, when they came home on their own and they had to make their own snacks.
But that wasn't, like, so bad.
No.
You know, because it made you more worldly, like ready to
independent,
trained, maybe trained for what life is going to give you.
Right,
you know?
And that's kind of where, you know, with Pete Jr., where I have a problem. You know, he's 9 years old, and I'm very unconventional. I raise him very unconventional. Some of it works perfectly, you know, in my opinion. And the way I think he's well-rounded. But there are things that he does that would be considered not well-rounded. So it's, you know.
You mean like walking around the house naked all the time?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a little odd.
Yeah.
But he's got some shame now. But you didn't raise him to be shameful of his.
No, there's never one point where I was like, you know. I mean, obviously when people came over, it'd be like, dude, put some pants on. So, you know, people are coming over. But yeah, he'd walk in my room and it's not like, you know, I was staring at him or anything.
Mm-hmm. He's
know,
like, so. But he's like a nudist. There's nothing wrong with that.
He just has
probably naturalist. Yeah, or naturalist.
He kind of lacks the shame. He likes to be comfortable. Like, when he stays over at his grandma's house, there's no issues. Like, he knows better. But right when he gets home, he's naked.
Trowels down.
Yeah.
Wow, so he really feels like this is my space to be naked in the house.
Yeah.
I know a guy like that. He's in his 50s, though.
So. Okay, that's a little creepy.
And then that's why the Jehovah's Witnesses don't visit him anymore.
Really? They don't visit me because my dogs.
They left something in your, like, under your door, though.
Yeah,
they
like,
they still
just slide this under here.
It's all folded in half, and it says, you know, says it has a happy family in a cornfield. Yeah. How come they're always in a cornfield? What is it about the cornfield?
Well, the cornfield fosters a sense of self, you know. I have no idea.
Whoa, I almost bought that one.
I know, it's so close. Seriously, though, a well-rounded kid not only has a healthy self-esteem, but they also have a strong self-identity, which I believe your boy does, is, you know, too. He knows who he is.
Yes, definitely knows who he is.
You know, with the younger ones, their world is you. The biggest thing is, his parents make it about them. So sometimes a kid's identity gets lost, and they don't get a chance to really understand that it's about them finding their, you know, freedom to express their individuality.
And I've asked him, you know, every year that he's played football, you know, it's always been his decision. You know, if you want to wrestle, if you want to do something, I don't care if it's playing the violin, learning the piano,
sure,
anything, but you have to do something. And so, you know, we go through our options, and he always picks, you know, one or two things, and he's always gone through it. I always make sure he finishes the job.
Yes, Pete's also a football coach and everything. I mean, he's very active in his son's life.
Oh, you know, that's great, man.
But that,
I didn't know that.
That helps, too. That all helps, because, you know, you be there with your kid's defeats and his wins, you know, the whole way around. And I'm sure you're not giving out participation trophies to everyone on the team if you don't win.
No.
I do think, though, that besides the regular varsity stuff, that I think parents are scheduling, just as an outsider.
I hate scheduling.
They're scheduling so many events now. The kid is being run around, and, like, there's, like, doesn't seem to be any downtime. You know, it's just running at such a high speed. I don't know if that's intended or not.
Some parents are just too busy.
Yeah, well, what they're doing is they're booking their kids. Play date, and, you know, there's no time to breathe at all for them.
Coming up, we got local musician John Frank. Also, what are the traits of that well-rounded kid?
Mm-hmm. And we've got some very, very succulent, juicy bits for you coming up next on Connections.
Wow, that made me hungry. Are you enjoying the show?
It's awesome. It's
like
great.
What we're doing?
Yeah, thank you. Well, I'm happy to be here.
Thanks.
That tea that you throw in there, I see.
No, yeah, I'll put it on the
PSP. Gary?
No,
this is good.
Oh, Gary?
Check out our ginormous
inventory
of over 650 Harley Davidson motorcycles. Take a test ride on the new 2017
order, please.
Oh, you want to slam that first?
Yeah, I don't know. I guess I was a little
bit. I'm going to toss that thing over the bucket and take it out.
I didn't hurry you. I'm sorry. What did you say, Melissa?
I said turn that one out, but didn't have to.
So now I'm just doing one right, because that's kind of what I'm tuning for.
One's live.
That's usually what we like, and then we'll talk about, you know, how you got into it.
Whatever you want to talk about.
Talk about your gigs, talk about our past.
Yeah, I sent Glenn and Mike. Well, I sent Glenn any of my gigs. Glenn had mentioned she wasn't doing anymore, and I didn't know that. But I can talk to you about this.
No, we got it.
It's all good.
It's ain't on for sure.
No, I when I found out you were doing it, it was really fun. And to answer your question, later is better. Early in the morning, the voice isn't quite.
Of course.
Six. Your show was early.
I mean, 5 a.m.
We're going to hear a whole other John Frank. This is nighttime. I like it. That's cool, man.
So I sat there today and listened, you know, just to listen to that song. I mean, honestly, it's awesome.
Thanks, man. I'm going to play that one. Yeah. Thanks, man.
I really like it.
Appreciate it.
That's DB. So we got him at the Hard Rock Hotel. I'll forward this to you too, porn star Pete, so you can have it for the upcoming shows. I'm gonna send it to PSP, that's cool. Can I use your PSP?
Yes, yeah. You guys are in for a treat. He's really good.
Yeah, this guy is really good. He played a friend of mine's very special time. He had a big wedding, and you know you got to choose who you're gonna play that. And he's been playing here for years. He was on Melissa Fox's old show, so it's kind of like a coming full circle kind of thing, which is cool. But yeah, porn star Pete. I mean, are we the luckiest men in the world, or what?
Yes, I believe sir. We are. Yes, sir.
And now we have the other luckiest man, John Frank.
I am. I'm lucky.
You know, we get to do what we love. This is something that not everybody is afforded. So. It's a good thing.
Do I
work Philly? So we'll have you on this. Yeah, and we'll have you on in about 12 minutes.
Yeah, just kind of cue me because I'm just kind of hanging out right now.
Yeah. You could just hang. Yeah, you don't have to say that.
I just hang out
here.
Fox.
Stop.
That's
wild, man. Parliament of Funkadelic. Dish TV is. That was cool.
Girl's out of control.
She really threw that. How long did it take her to throw that together? It was good. And get access to thousands of movies. And a lot of Funkification. People simply can't even compare. So the smart choice is to cut the cable and get Dish. Well, I know it's a bit. Great TV features, free HD
DVR upgrade, free installation, and free movie channels.
It's a show that's growing, so, I think we're putting out a real fun product. It really is. It's a really fun show.
Things take time.
Get Dish TV. 800-586-5036. But you know, you have to just go roll with the punches.
You don't stop.
That's it. You can't stop. Okay.
Come back for our juicy bits.
That is the best advice ever. Never stop.
That kind of stuff. Music.
Help me, I'm freezing my...
You're listening to Connections. Live from 10 to midnight on 1490 WWPRTFM, GabNet.net, and ConnectionsShow.com.
We have a pretty cool Twitter feed. Follow us at ConnectionsFM. We'll follow you back. Welcome to Connections. Really great to have you here. In just a little bit, we'll have musician John Frank on the show. Check out a little bit about him at johnfrankmusic.com. johnfrankmusic.com. Well, now it's time for some juicy bits.
You know why I'm playing this, right? You know what this is, right?
Yeah.
I think that story must be yours, so go ahead and kick us out, will you?
All right, well, you're not going to believe this. Marilyn Manson.
Crazy.
I'm singing this song right now. So, little Uzi Vert, I'm not sure who this is, but whoever it is, dropped $220,000 on a Marilyn Manson pendant.
So what? This is like a pendant that's loaded with like jewels, and like this is really worth about $250,000.
Yeah, it definitely got spiced up.
Oh, it's got 16,000 diamonds, totaling 155 carats on it, right?
Yes, yeah. And I think he was wanting to rock this at the Coachella.
Mm-hmm.
And this is incredible to me. I mean, Marilyn Manson is. You know, what would you call him? Great?
I've seen him live. It's an experience. It's definitely an experience. No, but, yeah, well, now, yeah, but wearing the Mickey cap.
Right, he's wearing a Mickey cap.
So it's not just any Marilyn Manson. He's Mickey Manson.
Well, that's because he's, like, from Lake County.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I'm really very confused, you know, by why somebody would do this. I mean, obviously, whoever this is has a lot of money.
Obviously.
Lil Uzi Vert, I have no idea who that is, but he was rocking it at Coachella, you're right.
Lil Uzi Vert.
Yeah, the celebrity jeweler Ben Baller made it.
That is the rapper du jour.
It's a $220,000, but the labor alone, putting in all those 16,000 diamonds, the labor alone was about $50,000 worth of work. So,
well, it was. He's not an old. He's a young guy. Was he born in '94? He's 22. Right. Obviously, he had a hit, some kind of hit that gave him the money to do it.
Something, yeah.
Something.
No idea who he is.
Yeah, his name is Symear Woods, but he goes by Lil Uzi Vert.
Well, he's a very clever name. You know, I follow my my MMA, right? And I've been waiting for a long time, but the update is here, but it's still not scheduled.
Yeah, they're making this very tricky on us.
They sure are.
I think they're setting it up for September, but that's just my opinion.
Conor McGregor and the Floyd Mayweather boxing match. It may happen soon. The Irishman is now narrowing in on the fight. He posted an update on his Insta account and said it looks like it's going to be announced very soon. My high performance training is live now. Sign up and join me in the preparation for my next fight being announced very soon.
So Floyd Mayweather. Who's been in the game for a long time, trying to branch out, right?
Well, it's interesting. I think it's really Conor trying to branch out, because he's going into...
I like Conor. I mean, he's...
I do, too.
He's about as good as they get.
And the Irish in me really wants him to win this one, but
yeah,
I've seen Mayweather fight, and he's kind of one of those guys that he'll hit you a few times, jump away, hit you a few times, and he's elusive. And I just see Conor McGregor just getting frustrated trying to get to this guy. And I don't think it'll last long. I hate to say it.
Well, it depends. The fight's billed as a boxing event. Again, it's not scheduled yet. No idea what an undercard's going to look like. Probably would be better undercard than the fight itself. All the build-ups, pretty much the deal. Right. But nothing's been mentioned quite yet. But they're going to build as a boxing event, so you're going to have boxing commentators, you know, Dave Bontempo, probably, and the Colonel Bob Sheridan will be there doing it. But others are suggesting the members of the MMA world could also be involved in the broadcast to keep it balanced. Either way, the announcement should be coming very soon at long last. So, you want one of these? Here, wait, let's do this.
I always, I didn't ask for one of those.
I like to get rid of that.
Gwen Stefani and, Blake Shelton may actually quit The Voice, as a rumor suggests. If you want to get rid of it, get rid of it. They are engaged. So are Gwen Stefani and Blake Shelton ready to part ways with the series that brought them together? This just means, really, that their contract is coming up for renewal. And so now they always talk about leaving before renewal time. So I bet it's renewal time.
I don't think they're actually engaged. I think rumor has it that they may be engaged.
This is rumor.
Mm-hmm.
They're a very annoying couple.
Yeah.
They're kind of mismatched, aren't they? I mean, Gwen Stefani and Blake Shelton.
Well, he was, you know, obviously he was with Miranda Lambert, and I think she was like 32, he was 40.
Mm-hmm.
And now he's with, you know, this 47-year-old.
So, Seven years older than him.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So maybe he wanted to, you know, get with somebody more mature, perhaps. But, you know, what really gets me is then they start pulling out these stories about Gwen Stefani saying, you know, I was thrown back by this whole thing, and then I realized that, you know, I was also getting a divorce at the same time, when in reality I think they're already doing it.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
It's covering the bags.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's pretty much how that goes, right?
I'm thinking that's what the deal, but it says right here that Blake and Gwen are no longer in the honeymoon phase of their relationship, but they still love each other very much and are very happy with each other. So what does that mean? They're not in the honeymoon phase. It means they're starting to fight.
It means they're not making people sick again with all their public displays of affection.
I think it's playing out. I think. What do you think? Give it another 2 months or 3 months?
Yeah, somewhere between there.
Yeah,
I think you're close.
Well, either way, yeah, I could care.
How about that April the giraffe?
Wait.
What?
You ain't jumping ahead that
way. Why can't I?
Because I want to hear about Dennis Rodman.
I might have gone back to him. I wanted to talk about the giraffe.
Too bad.
All right.
Dennis Rodman, forever one of the most misunderstood people and fascinating people in sports.
He's an interesting dude.
He just did a 30 by 30 documentary, which I will check out with him and the Detroit Pistons. It's affectionately nicknamed the Bad Boys. So we sat down with Joe Buck. Of course, we all know Joe Buck, the famous sportscaster. And his show is undeniable. And they discussed one of the darkest days of his life, when Rodman was sitting in his car with a gun outside of the Palace of Auburn Hills. And he said he had a life-changing experience. Something that saved me was the fact that I was listening to Pearl Jam a lot. So Mr. Buck said, Pearl Jam saved your life? And he said, pretty much. It's all I listened to the whole time. Credits the song Black, in particular, for essentially saving his life. He notes he became a Pearl Jam fan after he met Eddie Vedder, and followed the singer's suggestion to check out the band. So he went out and got the album 10, played it every day, and for some reason he says that song was on, and I think it saved my life.
Now, you see, I think the biggest story here is that he understood what Pearl Jam was saying.
Yeah.
I have no idea what any of that is.
So we all know that April the Giraffe had Oliver over the weekend, but what I did not know was that the vet got a kick in the old chumblies.
Yeah. And you can find it on YouTube.
Yeah, so check out the video on YouTube. Yep. Giraffe kicked veteran Deesh.
Well, we're going to be talking with our friend.
He's
getting choked up about it. It's connections.
And my guitar stays unplugged. Correct?
Yeah.
Okay,
it'll pick it all up
real
well.
So. That's fine. No, I just want to make sure I'm not missing anything.
No, baby.
But I appreciate the questions and the professionalism and all that good stuff, man. So, it's all good. Call us now. I'm glad you're here.
Yeah, I'm happy.
Thanks. We're all just trying to help each other.
Yeah, when we talk, speak into the mic. When you sing, you can back off and give me room sounds. And I'll make sure that way
I'll back off a little bit.
From over 100
That's my Clark Kent phase. All right. Listen to him warm up. Check him out. He's getting ready.
Stop, Andrew.
I'll tell him myself. Come on Spotify. I'll try to push where all my music is. My website's, it's fine, but I obviously didn't even update the events. And then, I only have so much music on there, so I want to direct them.
You need to get a, get a fan or something.
I know, you're right. Just that's just a widget, so I just have to plug it into the app.
It looks like you're taking a break.
Don't touch the little guy.
Call
a
recovering addiction specialist
now. Yeah, the little guy is one of
that. Yeah.
A little bit of
total rehab. Come here,
nobody. Don't you know Cobb to agitate it real fast?
Okay, got it.
I think all of us. Where are you from?
So I was born in Passaic, New Jersey, and I grew up in South Florida. I've been in Orlando 20 years.
Oh, nice. I lived in South Florida for almost 3 years.
That's Coral Springs.
He came up here. Oh, Coral Springs, right. I was in Miami. Okay, I know Coral Springs.
I spent a ton of time in Miami, but I went there enough to kind of be familiar.
Miami is good up to a certain point, and then you go, okay, I don't know Miami.
I'll go down to South Beach once in a while and party, but it's not anywhere I would live. That's just personal preference.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
It's too Miami. It's too much.
I don't feel like I was.
It's great. It's great to hit it for a weekend or.
I don't know if I can afford it. To be honest, man. It's so expensive down there to hang out and just have drinks.
It's very expensive.
But it's
fun. It used to be fun. It is fun. It's got the vibrancy.
It's pretty.
It's a good. It's a good singles town. It's a good town if you're single.
For sure.
Yeah.
I've been thinking about.
Thanks again for having me.
Oh, you're welcome. Very happy to have you. Is the mic position good for you? Everything's good for you?
Yeah, I'll probably back off.
Okay. So when you're talking, you can be closer?
Yeah, I'm talking. Yeah, cool. Got it. This will be fine if I'm playing, right?
Oh, absolutely.
J.P. Morgan is now holding a record 55 million ounces of silver. Goldman Sachs and HSBC.
Oh, is that what was it in this one?
No.
I don't need it, but I was looking for it.
In the bathroom. Hey, we're back again. Thank you, Andrew. Share.
Peter? Sharing is caring. Blackjack loves you. This is John Frank right here. And this porn star Pete. And that's the Foxy Lady.
Y'all know me.
What's not to love?
Hey Sean, hell yeah.
I got a little funny tonight.
Blackjack just coughed up a baby frog.
It might have been a baby giraffe for all I know.
Might have been a baby.
That was something. Was that a baby? What is that, fur ball? What the hell was that?
This is Connections, and I am Blackjack, and I got a great guy here named John Frank, who is a local musician who's been plugging away at it for a while and was on your show, right?
Yeah, way back in the day. Yeah, it was probably like 10-some years ago, right?
Yeah, at least.
That
for
a
sure.
While. Yeah. Did you hear yourself yet?
I do.
There he is. Look at that.
Well, John, welcome to Connections. Tell us a little bit about what kind of music you play and how you got into it.
The music I play, the songs I write, I guess they're considered adult contemporary pop rock. So they're melodic. I like to think they're catchy. I try to focus on the lyrics and the melodies. I guess my goal is that after you hear a song, whether you like it or not, it's going to be in your head.
Earworms.
Yeah, that's kind of the background I come from. It's what I listen to. So I think pop's a broad brush, but I like pop. There's Bieber pop, but then there's, John Mayer can be considered pop. I think popular music is really where.
When I listen to the song, I got a Beatles-esque kind of vibe. I mean, there was obviously different influences there, but I definitely got that where I felt like it was an easy song to sing to and harmonize to.
Melodic, very melodic.
Yeah, I'll take the Beatles any day.
Nice. So that's one of your influences. Who are some of your other influences?
I tell people anyone that really wrote, anyone that writes great songs is who I listen to. And that's, once again, that's subjective, but I do think that at the end of the day, most people can agree on a great song. They don't have to like it. It doesn't have to resonate, but, just as far as, what a great song is. So, if I was going to go through different, decades, I would say, Zeppelin is a big one from back then. Mm-hmm. Springsteen.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I love Billy Joel. I think he's one of the best American songwriters.
How about ELO? I love those guys too.
Yeah, I don't know too much about them. I know they're great, and I've heard some stuff, but I don't know a ton.
And then Fox and I like Floyd. We're big Floyd fans.
Well, I like your version of the Billy Joel Moving Out. That's what I'm playing right now.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. I figured. I want to put a cover on YouTube. I think it's important to do something a little different.
It is.
So I thought it was enough of a spin that people would be interested in.
Mm-hmm. It's very honest.
And then, we were talking about Pearl Jam earlier, that they were a band that, they were a band that I loved for years and years. And I actually saw them in New Orleans last year, and they were better now than they were 25 years
ago. Isn't that crazy?
I think it's just because they cleaned up a little and,
probably.
They're just not as... Mm-hmm. Strung out. Maybe not. These are all.
They're not as mumbly.
They're all assumptions.
They're all assumptions, but I mean, they're sound better. They just sound better. They sound better. I love Guns N' Roses. Was probably my favorite band for years and years. And they saw it. They sounded better last year too than they did 20 years.
So let me tell you, the best concert I saw ever was Madison Square Garden '91, and it was Guns N' Roses, right?
Yeah.
Soundgarden opened for.
Yeah, I saw that show New Year's Eve in South Florida.
Yeah. Fantastic.
And then Faith No More opened for them. So it was Faith No More, Soundgarden, and then Guns N' Roses. Yeah.
So you've got a few gigs coming up this week. Can we play at the Hard Rock Hotel? Now, is that the Velvet Lounge or Velvet Sessions?
Velvet Lounge. So it's just the bar in the hotel. It's an awesome little gig. It's cool.
It is a nice little gig. We've done it before. Wakaiva Island, what's going on there Saturday?
7 to 11. I'll be... There's a... There's an... Like a... I forget what they call it. There's a little side room. It's almost like a wine bar now. They've really built that place out. I've never been there in a while, but so yeah, I play there 7-11. It's cool. It's amazing. If you've never been to Wakaiba Island, it's
really
highly, highly recommend.
I love Wakaiba Island.
You know, I didn't even really know anything about it until I started playing there. I was like, oh my god. And I still haven't really got to. I haven't gone back just as a visitor. You know, I needed to go back and have a few beers and just enjoy myself. You know,
yes, it's beautiful. I Friday cell phone there. I was in the canoe and we were trying to go around the bend.
Yeah, so good.
Kind of lost there.
You lost yourself.
Yeah.
Where's the social house? Am I
social house is in Waterford Lakes over on, I guess, UCF side is the best way. East Orlando. It's a cool little bar. Used to be Friendly Confines years ago. There's still Friendly Confines.
Out there.
Well, in a different, like, I think on a lower 436, but this was like the original one.
The social house is like a tea party almost, because you're like from 1 to 4 in the afternoon, so kind of a late brunch.
Right? Like a late brunch, yeah, exactly. It's like cool. It's like their brunch, yeah.
Well, that's awesome.
Yeah, it's cool. Yeah, it's a good crowd, always fun.
But John Frank is with us today, and I wanted to perform something. What song are you going to do for us?
I'm going to do a song that's off my newest record. It's called Love. The record's called Bobby Pins and Cigarettes, but the song is called. Love Will Find a Way.
Cool. You'll have to ask about that later.
Right. Yeah, when I saw it on the side, I went, ooh, I like the name.
Yeah, it's fun. Okay, anytime you're ready.
Well, I've been thinking about my ways. I've been thinking about the days when I never had to worry for my heart. Back when I was young, and the things that could become didn't vanish with the taillights in the dark. I just need something to get by tonight. Yeah, I just need something to get by tonight. When the like a stone, am I better off alone? Will I never find someone to say I do? Your life is like a maze, and I'm in this whiskey haze, just wondering how I'll ever make it through. Well, I just need something to get by tonight. I just need someone to get by tonight. When the rain comes falling down and the world I've known stops spinning around, I will never lose my faith. I will rise above, yes, love will find a way. And the world we've known stops spinning round. We must always have our faith. We will rise above, yes, love will find when the rain comes falling down. And the world I know stops spinning around. I will never lose my faith. I will find a way, yeah, find a
Yeah, man, good stuff.
Nice, man. Really enjoyed that.
Was that based on anything in particular, or is that just words that came out your heart?
I mean, they're both. I mean, that song in particular, I don't think I was thinking of a particular person or necessarily a particular event, but definitely like a kind of an accumulation of some stuff. And it's definitely very personal, but I can't say what's about this girl or that girl or, you know, and I try to write it from a standpoint that maybe everyone can kind of understand, mm-hmm. you know, a little more of a wordly kind of.
I like it.
I appreciate it.
I wouldn't compare yourself, though, to John Mayer. I'd say John Mayer likes to be like John Pine.
Yeah, and I've never really compared myself to him or too many other people. I just, you know, I like who I like.
Right.
You have your own style.
In the elevator pitch, though, everyone always wants to know, who do you sound like?
Yeah, and I, you know, when bands say, well, I don't really sound like anyone, that comes off as a little arrogant because mm-hmm. I think there's a point of reference
sure,
for everybody.
Influence.
But I just, you know, I definitely have been doing it a while and I kind of sound like me. And then there's like Beacon, I'm sure if you listen enough, you kind of see where I'm coming from as far as influences, but I couldn't try to sound like someone else if I tried. I just couldn't.
I agree. You can only sound like John Prine.
Well, you definitely have a unique clarity to your voice, and when we sat around before I got here with some friends and listened to it, and, you know, everybody basically said the same thing. It was really hard to compare, and you know, so that's why when I came up with kind of like the Beatles-esque, it's, you know, it had that
mm-hmm.
where you could
well it's melodic, you want to harmonize, you understand the words and what you're saying and the feelings that are coming through it, or at least I'm able to, you know, put my feelings on but
as hearing that fresh new sound,
right,
you know, that you're hearing these days.
No, I appreciate it. You know, and it's kind of, I think it's a double-edged sword if you don't sound like a ton of other people, especially from a business aspect, because the business really kind of needs to lump you in with people. So, like, if someone were to come out right now that sounded Maroon 5's, I mean, they're great, but I think they're kind of doing whatever they want now. But if, you know, when Maroon 5 blew up, like, I remember it was like back in MySpace days, there was like 30 bands that started sounding like Maroon 5, and a few of them got deals, but if ultimately I don't know if anything happened because they're kind of riding a wave that was
Music business, you know, always does that. And so the music business changes so often.
So I think if you sound different, I think it takes a lot longer, but maybe the payoff's better.
Probably.
You know, that's a theory.
A working theory. No, I think it works. You know what I'm saying? Really.
And at least you go in being true to yourself.
Right. So JohnFrankMusic.com. John's upcoming stuff, including the Velvet Room, Velvet Lounge of the Hotel, Hard Rock Hotel, which is a lot of fun.
So did you say Hard Rock? That's all other level.
Rock Hard. I said hotel, rock hard. I said it all backwards. It's like total word dyslexia.
Rock hard.
Wakaiba Island on Saturday evening and the Social House Sunday up at Waterford.
But it's only rock hard when John Frank's played at that particular location.
Yeah, and any of time, I have no idea.
I hope you couldn't see that on the camera.
Yeah. Are you going to be buying one of the Elvis outfits or in a smaller lounge at the Hard Rock?
Actually, I already broke the glass. Yeah.
Oh, no!
Mazel tov!
Yeah.
That's what we say.
I'm going to wear, like, a first suit, the suit Elvis passed in, you know, just to really for effect.
John Franks, thank you so much for coming in, man. It's great to see you again.
Yeah,
so
yeah, I really appreciate being here.
Well, don't make yourself a stranger.
Don't be a stranger.
Absolutely not.
I'm going to take you out to the break with the song called Let Me In by John Franks on Connections.
Thank you.
All right, John Frank, I didn't tell you this, but it's kind of funny because one of my family name, part of it, my great-grandmother was Frank, and they were Jewish people from Germany and Poland area or something like that.
So it's
kind of interesting.
Yeah, I'm adopted, so I don't know much about like
Facebook thing.
Yeah, you're right.
Good day, boys and girls. You like that? That's
good,
John
huh?
Frank. All new Milwaukee. I haven't seen this guy. I think he's 12.
Yeah, dude. I know. You know how I know? I was dating a girl. I remember spending the night with her. I remember spending the night and doing to wake up. I remember she woke up early and she was like, I just started. I was barely doing the mics and I didn't have a record out. And I remember she said I was crying all. You know, but I remember that particular. So that was. I think her and I broke up in 2005. So that means it was 2004, roughly.
Right.
It's been a while.
Good job. I'm glad you're still hanging in there, Dad.
No, no.
And I don't know what this black hat John Frank is on YouTube. If that's your alter ego.
So did you want to hang out with us a little longer? Did you want to head out? What did you want to do?
Oh, yeah, I'm good. No, thanks. I appreciate having you.
Did you have to come forward again? Are you
a licensed CDL truck driver?
Oh, that's cool.
Are you yeah, John was actually at the Twitter and Tim, like, there's not really fit on the road. I was there and I hopped on.
We're the friendly and safe gasoline transport company. That's interesting.
To apply for available local CDL truck driving opportunities, please visit
dbtrucking.com.
That's just talking to my my peoples. The, I'm still trying to figure out a name from the Connexions. Obviously, that one didn't work, so I won't be using that one.
No, didn't work.
Didn't feel right. No.
It's a little off. All right. One, three times, are you playing with it?
I'm glad to see you're still doing it, too. Now, are you? I saw Linda's car there. Are you still with Linda? That's amazing. That's something proud of.
Yeah, you know, telling me.
Does she still play out?
She hasn't played out in a while. She's got her own big studio on the other side of the house over there.
Yeah.
And, we're doing Spanish dubbing for sporting events. For, you know what company called Fight Sport, which is all over the internet. Yeah. But she's also recording. She's doing all our liners and our voiceovers half here.
Because the Beatles kept working from your haircut.
Yeah,
she's
kind of
working out.
She had a burned out.
I'll tell you, it would have been her in the
contract
if I was going away.
You got to evolve. I mean, I'm up in mass school a lot. I'm starting to core. I'm starting to, you know, I'm probably going to move there ultimately, honestly. Like, if anything else is going to happen for me, I don't think Orlando is the place. And I like Orlando, but it's not here.
That's
what I'm doing.
She went there for 6 years, worked in some guitar, you know, back on the day.
Before?
Yeah, before she came back, before I ever met her.
Okay.
So do you like the concept and what we're doing? We're doing something that hasn't been done in a while, but has a track record of success called Relationships Radio. And so it's a genre talk radio, but it's good. It's our time. I think people want to connect more. I think they're getting more disconnected with all the technology, and they want to connect more. So that's kind of the purpose of this thing. To connect people through humor, and then, you know, help them be better too. You know, we throw a little sexy in there just for fun. You know, everybody likes it.
I think you can't really go wrong with this.
I think it's a really good. I think it's a really good. Thank you. I think it's a really good concept, and I like what you're doing. You know, you're putting it right out there. I mean, you got to be real and true to what you're doing. When did you first get into the music stuff? How old are you?
I'm a master. I played piano as younger. I do that. I play piano too. Not.
That's cool.
But I started playing that when I was young, but I wasn't very good, and I kind of didn't follow up on it.
All right,
you're very good. Really
I'm going to move the energy from your thighs to your buttocks now.
Well, good for you.
Now, which one of you doubts my powers? You, Lieutenant Weinberg.
Are you feeling? I like this.
No, I'm just getting warmed up.
Are you feeling? I don't know, was that like the best rejoin ever or what? Because we're just getting warmed up.
Nunez Productions kicking some serious butt. Check them out, nunezproductions.com, if you like imaging for your radio show. What the hell, right?
Well, I might as well throw one to Randy Thomas, too, the voice of Connections. Sure. Also the voice of the Oscars, the Emmys, the Kennedy Center Honors. Wherever you see a big gathering of people giving stuff to each other, Randy Thomas's voice is right there.
Yeah, she's the bomb diggity. So we're talking tonight about a lot of things, but mostly how to have a well-rounded kid. As you know, we do relationship radio here. So a lot of times we need to talk to you parents about, you know, the kids. And if you wish all kinds of good qualities in your kid, well, guess what? Ain't no fairy godmother, ain't no Cinderella store. You cannot wave a wand over your kid and make all these good qualities happen. Guess what? It's your job. I mean, there are traits that you need to instill into your kids, and we'll tell you here how, but, yeah, it's up to you really to make it happen.
It is really always up to the parent. Mm-hmm. That's it. Whether it's a single parent or both parents, I think that you can have the right and correct influence, because it all starts at home, I guess, really. Mm-hmm. You know, to make that good kid, you gotta just do what you gotta do.
Well, you gotta make them happy, right?
Yes.
You gotta make them feel loved, you know, you gotta make them feel like they're important and special.
Well, I know that, you know, the happiness, obviously, as a matter of fact, I asked Capen one time, which is Pete Jr., mm-hmm. you know, I asked him, what is the meaning of life? And this is something I asked him at like 5 years old. You know, to you, what is the meaning of life? And he said,
cookies.
Candy, right? Oh, he did. Did he have it that early?
And I looked at him and I said, you know, that's the best answer I think I've ever heard in my entire life.
And he was five?
Yeah. So simple, but yet so profound.
Right. You know? Well, when your kids ask you stuff like, hey, you know, why is the sky this color? Instead of saying, you know, I don't know, give an answer for God's sakes. Figure it out. Look it up together, you know. Find an answer that they can understand on
that. That's a great idea. It's a great idea.
But for those people to just shut them down, I mean, curiosity is one of the things that helps you raise a good kid. They got to be curious about stuff.
That's funny because when, you know, my mom dropped out after the eighth grade. I don't even think she got through the eighth grade.
Right.
And so she always used that. You know, we asked her something, you know, how many times we've heard, you know, I only graduated to the eighth grade, you know, went to the eighth grade, uh-huh. So...
What are you asking me?
Go to the library. So
right. Right. Whereas, yeah, you got to help them become smart. You have to help them become outgoing. And smart, if you don't have it, like you were saying earlier in the show, Pete, a lot of the parents now are not bilingual. They speak Spanish or another language, and then their kids are bilingual, and they have to translate and bring that. That takes away the childhood. You know, that's tough on the kids because they literally have to be adult and negotiator and translator. But one thing maybe it will help them is to be taught to be respectful, you know, because I do find in bilingual families that the kids have generations there, too. Like you were talking about, grandmother's still there, grandfather may still be there. And, boy, that shoe comes up, that kid shuts up. I mean, that's pretty cool.
I had the shoe. Did you have the shoe?
I had the belt.
You had the belt.
Yeah, the belt was always the big
one. I had the MIT pledge paddle. Thank you, Dad.
You had the MIT pledge paddle?
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Piece of wood. He'd come in cracking it on his hand.
Did it have the holes in it so that the air went through it?
Nope. It was a big old paddle in it from MIT when he pledged up there. So.
Yeah, for some reason, my dad always wore a belt, too. It was horrible.
Mm. With little hooks on it to catch the meat.
Oh!
Yeah, depends how mad he was on what side he went.
So what happens when he got mad? You said there was a sign that you guys saw when he got mad.
Yeah, he would stick out his tongue and it would go to one side. And he'd bite down.
That's when the whole limbic system kicked in and then shut down the rest of the brain. And that was it.
Yeah,
it was just pure animal.
You knew he was no longer parenting you as you know, what's best for you or best for him. Yeah. He's doing this completely out of anger at this point.
Yeah, it's not a good thing.
It's usually when, you know, you pissed off mom.
But the traits that you really want to do, we said happy, we said outgoing, we want to teach them to be smart and respectful. But we also need to teach them to be obedient. So chores around the house, things like that, learning to do things because they're told to, not to stop. It's kind of military. Do what I say, don't sit there and think about it. When I say jump, don't ask how high, just start jumping. And you find that your son is obedient?
I'm very weak with this. This is one of my downsides, yeah.
Okay.
Because and it's both me and Mrs. Pornstar. We kind of, you know, let him get away with everything.
John Frank liked that you call your wife Mrs. Pornstar.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
Isn't that clever?
I'm sure Missy is laughing too.
But yeah, we you know, it's. I'm not going to say, because I definitely have a line and have a limit, and he's aware of that limit, and he's obedient to that limit. But I am so lax.
Right.
You know, so...
Follow through,
really
my friend.
Hard for him
you gotta,
to push that limit. So when he does, I tend to get a little more upset because I'm like, you know, all this room I'm giving you, and you know, it's that, you know, inch and mile.
Well, they're gonna test you, right?
Oh yeah.
I remember when I was a little bastard, I used to really test my mom. You know, I was a little hard to raise. I was a little rambunctious. Always used to kind of trip and hurt myself or cut myself on something.
That does not surprise me.
You know what?
Fuck
yours, Fox. I love you.
I'm not looking at you. Are you giving me a finger?
No. There was no finger there.
Oh, okay.
There was no finger. But, no, I was a little bit hard.
A little bitch, do you say? I'm sorry.
No, don't talk about yourself like that.
Oh, no.
Now, what were you? Were you rambunctious? Were you a little hard to handle when you were a kid?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I was.
Porn star Pete?
I was eager to please until I was 13.
And then what happened? Rebellious?
Hormones kicked in.
Oh boy.
And I started worrying about how do I get chicks.
So how did your voice sound before you hit puberty? Was it higher or?
You know, one day I will put the video up. I have a video of me talking at about 11 years old. It's really high pitched and I sound Canadian. So you won't even recognize the voice.
And you have the deepest voice of all your brothers, right?
It kind of runs in the family. We all have pretty deep voices.
Well, Scott's wasn't that deep.
Yeah.
It's yours. Anyway, we can take a break here.
That's right. We got our own porn star Pete coming back. We got a Fox Office review and the news thing and oh, so much else.
Yeah.
It's connections.
Thanks again for having me. I really appreciate it.
John, that's what we do.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you so much. It's always good to talk. All right. Yeah, you want to pack it in and Jack will get you out of here.
I really enjoyed it.
Thanks, man. Yeah, I really did.
Yeah, very chill, very cool. Love your sound. I'll be around.
I know you will. Keep in touch, man.
Absolutely. And, you know, send your guys if you know all your musician guys.
Send me some good people, for
sure. Anyone you think that would benefit.
Yeah, you know, it's hit me up.
Okay, I will, for sure.
Later.
If you can't afford your student loans or your past due and you need help, you must call right now.
Nice hour. That was a nice hour. So what do we got here? Do we have some kind of candy of some kind?
What are we looking at?
Oh, yeah, that's Lizzie left some.
So Lizzie said the ears were gone, but they weren't.
That's the chocolate.
She She thought the ears were gone, but they weren't.
This is the bunny one. Oh, we should open up the... Let's open up the...
You can have that. I don't
want that. Oh, you think this one's going to not be so good?
I told you never try. Trying to get me with the chocolate.
Is that kind of like the... That's like the cheaper
chocolate?
See
how they do?
Dish TV is funny money is good, though. TV. Here's why. Dish has the nation's lowest TV price, along with an award-winning DVR that can skip commercials, record 8 shows at once, and get access to thousands of movies at your fingertips. Cable simply can't even compare. So the smart choice is to cut the cable and get Dish. Plus, you get all these great TV features.
That free HD DVR,
free installation. I couldn't get it. Oh, what, the glasses?
Yeah.
Limited time offer, 24-month commitment, and credit qualification required. Cancellation fee, monthly equipment fees,
what?
And other restrictions apply. Promotion what? Can change at any time.
What?
This is Connections.
Well, I don't know if that's true, but I saw that. I'll talk about it. Thank you. Gotta go.
Foxy Fox.
I do have a lot of people that ask questions on the thing here about the kids.
Oh, that we should answer?
Yeah.
Boy, we ate like pigs, didn't we? Welcome to the show.
I did. Mine's still here. Oh, you mean yesterday?
Oh, absolutely.
We fattened like an Easter ham.
Yeah, I watched you.
Yeah, we were piglets. I never did see those pictures. Did you put them up?
No, I didn't. You know, I should have, but I got to do that. I just kind of took them and It would just kind of for me for a little bit, you know.
As you know, this is our foreplay, also known as soft open.
Happy Easter to everybody. Hope you had a great one. I hope you had a great Passover, whatever you celebrated last week. It was it's quite an interesting week because we're in Mercury retrograde for another 2 weeks. This is this is a time of different, you know, changes, rebirths, time of you know, different things happening. And we got that tarot guy that we're going to have on soon. He's talking about some stuff happening.
We get
like
that guy,
right?
I would love to, yeah.
Well, come hit him up, man.
He's all about it.
What's his name, Al? I think his name's
his
Al.
His name is Al. Yeah. Of course it is.
Yeah, he's very charismatic. I really like him.
Yeah,
so
he's also money with his predictions. Readings. I mean, that Eight of Cups thing the other day was...
How about that Eight of Cups thing?
Ooh, yeah.
Well, that slapped you upside the head, didn't it?
Yeah, that slapped me upside the head and called me Sherlock's what it did. And I was like, what the... Hey, wow, this guy's reading the palm.
That was my mom's name, Shirley. Believe
my mom's name was Shirley.
Well,
whoa.
Now I'm really retro.
We had the same name for our moms.
Is your dad the same name too?
I don't know. My dad was Jack.
Glenn.
Okay. But we got Shirley's,
yeah,
man.
Shirley.
That's pretty crazy stuff right there. I mean, that's like kids.
Probably both named after Shirley Temple.
Yes, they were both.
Yeah.
But my mom was 1932. That was when she
36.
Was born. Okay, so same.
Gee whiz.
Tell you what, Pornstar Pete, it's just something else that bonds us together.
Yes.
Makes us feel a little, I don't know, a little verklempt.
When we get back, we're going to talk to our Facebook Live feed people. Appreciate that. Check us out at Connection Show, one word. A lot of questions on the topic, which is how to raise a decent kid.
And it's great to be here on GabNet Live. GabNet.net.
You got 2 minutes.
Have you been thinking
whose name was Martha? Oh, we gave
Washington.
For less than $3.
Oh yeah, yeah. How about? Because really, there aren't that many women named Shirley.
Well, Missy's also got this thing that she thinks Melissa and my mom are a lot alike.
Want more? We'll give you
kind
of brings it full circle when she said Shirley.
And four more pills
and then
free. You save more than $500.
You
have to be a rocket scientist to know what to do next.
It really is.
Call 800-814-5131.
Crazy world, folks.
Well, there's all kinds of connections that we just don't see.
Overpaying for Viagra. Call us and start saving a ton of money.
And they become our friends.
Ordering is fast and easy with your pills delivered to your door in an unmarked package. Call us right now. 800-814-5031.
And friendships are treasures, man.
That's 800-814-5031. To the parents of the campers.
It's all about treasuring your friendships, right, guys? See, I'm wearing bonkers tonight. They're one of our partners, and they're great if you like comedy. Stand-up comedy, nobody does it like Bonkers does.
Seen from
so Bonkers in your area,
hotels.
I bet.
I'm sorry that didn't prevent me from taking them hiking.
And if there isn't, there will be shortly.
I forgot the GPS. I'm sorry when I ran back for it, I noticed the milk.
What the hell is that?
Tent. I'm sorry.
What? John Wild posted something, I have no idea what the hell that is. I
lost all track of time.
Is it some kind of a toy, or is it a remote control, or is it a game? Is it like an old football game?
Choppers,
some weird.
I'm sorry when I found
I'm just curious. It looked
really
good. Funky.
I'm sorry your children still night.
It stumped us both.
I'm sorry.
That's hard to do.
Film rights to their story. I'm sorry. I was eating a Milky Way. Always prepare.
We need to get some portraits done. Some kind of like professional photographs of us for the side. I think that'd be fun. Something that looks cool. A couple group shots. You know. I think we should.
Hi, baby. No cheese. Go lay down. Come on, go lay down. Connections is relationship
radio. When Pete Jr. was 6 months old, that's when I realized I was a father.
Connections is relationship radio.
Well, he was born with club feet. And so they put a lot of casts on him, and you know, I got to bond with him during those 6 months. But still, it really didn't click to me that, you know, I'm a father, you know, this is real, that you know, I could be pretty good at this or pretty bad, I didn't know. But at this moment, 6 months, they took his last cast off, he had to put one more on there, and And so they took a scalpel on both of his ankles and split right through the Achilles heel.
Aye.
Oh.
And then bent him up and put casts around him.
That's how they fix that, right?
Yeah. Right. And this whole time, you know, I started thinking, I mean, I was horrified. You know, this is somebody I'm supposed to protect. And here he is looking at me crying like, you know, what did you just let them do to me? And it was that moment where I realized, you know, this is real. You know, these feelings I feel, these fatherly feelings, they're real, you know. And it only grew from there.
Point star Pete, man. That's a nice story, man.
It is. It's a good story. It fits right in, of course, because we're talking about how to raise a well-rounded child. And we've got a lot of people listening on our Facebook Live feed, checking us out. What's up? Because they like the visual thing. And Flora said she raised her kids with humor, sarcasm, and honesty, and it's worked so far. And her kids are well-rounded because she's a good cook. So they're like a circle.
Oh, and she is funny, too.
Flora. Yeah, Rachel said, my baby's 18, and nothing is like it when he was a child. Parents,
and they grow up so fast.
Parents turn to electronics for babysitters, and parents themselves are stuck in electronics. It's very sad.
Yes, it's definitely a different world.
We're talking about the good kids. What happens when your kid's a brat?
Well, Sean said, parents, you know, we want to know what you guys think about why kids feel it's okay to make a mess at home, but they try to act their best when they're anywhere else.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Well, it's the same reason caping gets naked, probably. More comfort zone, right?
And you feel less, you know, you're not embarrassed when you're at home and your kid does these things, but all of a sudden you find, you know, reality hits you when you're in a restaurant and you're like, oh my God, I'm raising an animal.
Yeah. Jeez.
That's not a comforting feeling.
No.
I mean, how do you stop it?
My immediately, goodness. That's how
it's kind of nip it in the bud, just yeah. nip it.
I don't get mad often. He has rarely seen me angry, but when I use it, you know, it works.
Right. Do you just get, like, even deeper, boys?
Well, here's one. One of the signs is they try to control your life. That's one sign.
Well, you know, first of all, if your kid's in the drugstore throwing condoms all over the place and ignores you when you ask him to stop, starts kicking, screaming, you know, and all this craziness, do you just ignore and walk away? That's what I do. That's not my kid.
Oh, I run. I don't even, like, hang around.
I mean, a lot of parents have embarrassing days, and some of their kids can be bratty as all heck. Sometimes they just need a nap, but, you know, when kids go from sweet girl to Satan in seconds when they don't get their way, that is an issue.
Oh, that's an issue. And you can't say anything to the kid of another parent. Remember how you, in the old days, you could say, you know, don't do that.
And
the
parent would kind of, you know,
the parent would kind of support you. Now the parent's going to send them, do a lawsuit against you for talking bad to the kid. Mm-hmm. Holy cow.
Yeah, and I've never had that problem in my situation, but, you know, I would kind of agree with those. You know, if my son was being out of line and I didn't recognize it, because when I see it, I'm not going to say I approach these people, but the first thing I think about is, where are the parents going wrong? I don't really get the kid and go, you know, but the parents...
Yeah, because it's not the kid's fault. It's the way the kid's being raised.
Exactly, you know? When they're that young.
Exactly what we're talking about. And if you're being a permissive parent, here are some things that are going to happen. Your kid's probably going to turn into a brat.
You mean always giving them their way? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, if yes is the only word that you know, and no doesn't come out enough, you're going to have a problem. And so we've got seven signs that your kid's probably a brat if there are constant throwing of temper tantrums, okay? Maybe he hits, grabs, or acts bossy. Does she whine from the moment she wakes up? She act defiant and negotiate every time? I mean, because there should not be a negotiation with a 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 15-year-old.
No, especially when they're throwing the temper tantrum.
It has to be the parent's way.
Yeah, I mean, there's no, it's not a debate. Go clean your room. Eat your green beans. It should not be a debate. I mean, my brother fell asleep at the plate several times. He was left at the dinner table. You remember this story?
Yeah.
He was left at the dinner table because he wouldn't finish his food. And one night we came back out. It was like 10 o'clock. Came back out. Brother's still laying there. And he'd fallen asleep in his mashed potatoes. And was holding onto a cup of milk, which he dumped on his head. And when he woke up, it was like, ooh. And, you know, but that's how my parents, they'd bring it out the next morning. My mom put it in the refrigerator, and she'd bring it out, and there was your breakfast.
Yeah.
Not going to waste food, starving kids and eat the rope, yeah. So,
That's definitely hardcore, but
that's pretty hardcore, but
yeah.
Yeah, but I remember those. Yeah. But I never, my mom never did that one. Not with the food good. One.
What if they complain about being bored? I'm bored. I'm bored.
I get that a lot.
Yeah. Don't play basketball.
I don't get the temper tantrums.
That's
good. He can reason with me. I taught him how to talk at a very young age, so he can reason with me.
Well, negotiation and reason are two different things, really. When they start saying, I'll do this, I'll go ahead and do that, but you're going to have to give me this. Okay, that's a negotiation.
Right.
Reasoning is a little different. Maybe they have, hey, well, you said I could, or it would be really good for me to stay up and watch. If he comes up with a valid reason why I should be on the internet for another half hour studying for something, that's one thing. But just trying to negotiate, always saying, I'm not going to do this unless you do this for me, or I want to go here, I'll clean my room, but you're going to have to take me to the movies, or buy me a video.
Yeah, too much deal making.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Don't always have to make a deal.
Another thing is, I've noticed it too, they talk rudely to their own parents, and then to their friends, you got a problem.
Yeah, I don't like that.
There's a big problem there. And finally, if that kid controls your life and everything that you do is because of your child, that is a big issue. And you can get help. You can love your kid. You don't have to spoil them. Don't you agree?
Yes, definitely.
You can spoil the hell out of them. Why not? That's the only time they're going to get spoiled. I mean, look at how much life throws at you, man.
No, that's
you got to give them a little
that's
something.
That's what grandparents are for.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
So the grandparents spoil.
Yeah.
See, my grandparents spoiled me.
I try to go by this. And, I try to go by it as best as possible, but it's parent first, friend second, because my kid is my friend. So sometimes it is hard to separate those, but, he'll tell you, this is where I get the reasoning. He goes, I know, father first, friend second.
Oh, so he's understanding.
Yeah, he's very bright this way, where I can talk to him and he'll understand where I'm coming from.
That's a very good thing to teach the kid, man.
Yeah. And he does care about what other people are feeling, which I notice a lot of kids don't have that ability at this age.
No, they're kind of narcissistic now.
They can be, but keep in mind, a lot of this goes, and most of this goes back to the parents. And if both parents work or start feeling guilty for spending too much time at the office, or they just can't stand seeing their kid cry, or maybe they're too tired to deal with it, what happens is permissive parenting. And you get a bunch of kids who feel like they're entitled. Because being permissive usually involves bribing, pleading, and often just giving in. And it means that you should say no, but then you start saying probably not, and then I'm not sure, and then all of a sudden your child has way too much power. And that's a bad thing.
Bad thing.
Oh yeah. You can expect a tantrum maybe from a preschool age child. Sometimes they just can't be avoided. But if it starts erupting any time that you have a limit that you've set, that's a problem. First of all, don't have a tantrum yourself. That's how you handle it.
Yes.
You're being empathetic. You let him know that you recognize he's angry, but his behavior is not acceptable. And that you help him find the right words. That's where the words come in. Find some words to express how you feel, and you can take a privilege away or give it a timeout or whatever that crap is they call it now. If the situation calls for it. But that doesn't mean send them to the room where all the electronics are. That means you sit them in a corner where they watch the paint just kind of dry. And literally, I was set in a corner.
Yeah, they got to feel it. They won't feel it by going to their room. It defeats the purpose.
It does. Because the room's a happy place.
Yes, definitely is happy.
See, kids learn real quickly how far they have to go to manipulate mommy and daddy. So what you need to do is tell your child, I don't like it when you speak like this, and I cannot understand you. Though you're not going to respond until she stops screaming, uses her regular voice. Because remember, an unhappy child is not an unloved child. In the short term, sure, it's not pleasant for you, but kids need to learn that they cannot always get what they want, period. Okay? And that's why I say I'm always so negative about these participation trophies. Okay, not everybody wins. Not everybody wins.
Nope, sometimes you win, sometimes you lose.
And you have to learn to be a good loser.
Yes.
You have to acknowledge that someone did better than you, and, and that's how it is. And it all leads back to the parents. Unfortunately, I'm blaming you tonight.
Well, if it's any
It's in a bonus.
He doesn't get participation trophies.
Okay.
They've actually tried to give him.
Yeah.
Yeah, we went against it.
Good. Oh, yeah, that's why you left, right? That's why you took
it. Well, no, but it led up to it. They added up
it led to up that. To it, I'm sure. When we come back, I'm going to give you some movie reviews. We call it the Fox Office. Watched a couple of flicks, and I'm going to let you in on it.
Fox Tales galore, right here on Connections.
A few.
I love this one. Yeah. It's an oldie. It's a good one.
It's like you guys.
Yeah. That was nice.
Very nice, guys. Very nice.
Very nice, Melissa Fox. I thought she really took charge of that one and had fun with it.
Well, yeah, because I'm not a parent, that's what makes it more fun, because I'm not yelling at me later. Yeah, what you talking about? You're not a parent.
Yeah, right, right. Because, you know, they can't wait.
But I did raise a child. A boy. He's 27 now. Musician. And Nate, or... Is he Nashville? No, he's in Texas. He is destroying our sex life. I know
just how you two must feel, but Bob and I... Well, check that picture out, John. Check that picture out, Pornstar B. The Adam Bomb, huh? But, like, I've never seen that clear of a picture.
Hey, Bob.
It
takes a couple of weeks to
get things going. Forces of nature, huh?
Did I review Skull Island?
No, I don't think... Did you? I don't think you did. No. I think we were talking
yeah,
about it.
Yeah, I was going to.
It wasn't too shitty. I didn't do the one, the rabbit, though.
I've held back so far.
Yeah. Find sexy events. MixandSexy.com is your one-stop shop with no restrictions. It's all up to you. How sexy do you want to be? Sky's the limit at MixandSexy.com. Summer Holly invites you to their April riding season events. Stop in now and check out our ginormous inventory of over 650 Harley Davidson motorcycles. Take a test ride on the new 2017 model. Nice spot, Fox.
Plus, get your best rates on high-quality pre-inspected motorcycles before they're gone. We'll even pay off your trade. All applications accepted. Enjoy free concerts all weekend long. Stop by Saturday for Queens of the South annual picnic. Sheila and the Sound of Barfly on Sunday. Both shows start at noon. Visit 7oharley.com for more info. See you there.
Are you a licensed CDL truck driver? Are you looking to join a leader in the trucking industry? DB Trucking, with locations in Tampa and
Florida. I never understood why people... I mean, I know, but why do people always show their injuries? And, like, they do the... Like, I don't want to see this! Show me a baby or a cat. I need to see your incision! Especially if it's festering.
Do you use Viagra or Cialis? Have you been thinking about trying Viagra or Cialis? What if we could promise you the same results for less than $3 a pill? If you're paying $20
yeah, take a look at my festering incision wound.
Our pill delivers the exact same results for less than $3.
Will
the
doctor
save more than $16 a pill for the same?
What, but posted it?
Want more? We'll give you 40 blue pills or 40 yellow pills for $99 and add 4 more pills free. You save more than $500. You don't have to be a rocket scientist to know what to do next. You need to call 800-814-5031 and get your 44 pills for just $99. Stop overpaying for buying.
Oh, this is cute. The kidney stone is talking to the other two kidney stones and said, I'm sorry, kids, but last night your father passed. 800-814-5031. It says a difficult day for the kidney stone family. 814-5031.
We now join America's most popular show already in progress.
Does anybody know what the hell is going on?
Two words. Archless bandy.
Well, what's going on in the movies?
Well, this movie came out a little bit ago, back in March, but, you know, I finally got a chance to see it on the big screen, and that would be Kong Skull Island.
King Kong.
Did you see that yet?
I just saw it last night.
What'd you think? Yeah?
I enjoyed it.
Was it a winner?
I love the hero points by Peter.
Well, yeah. You know, I did. Well, I'm trying not to give anything away.
Don't give anything too much away.
But I did think that they took some routes that were different, and I appreciated that. I was afraid that I'd see the same thing.
Now, this isn't like the Eighth Wonder of the World stuff. They don't drag him back to New York. He doesn't hang on the Empire State Building. Okay, it's not that. It's about the Skull Island part, and Kong Skull Island. If the parents were thinking about dropping the kids off, I'd say 12 of them. Okay, because it's very violent. It's action-packed. It's a reboot of the King Kong story. It is set in the 1970s. Has a lot of grabbed video leading up to this. And it's basically about a group of scientists on a mission to survey a mysterious island in the Southeast Asian area.
And they don't know Kong's there, then?
Oh, no. They know something's there. But they're there basically just to do land surveying. At least that's the guys. Then they encounter several dangerous giant creatures, including an ape, trying to protect his habitat, some giant birds, a spider, octopus, and some reptilian creatures. Things get brutal, victims get dismembered, stomped on, eaten, tossed about, helicopters crash and get ripped apart. So you can expect a high body count. With scene after scene of jump-worthy action, death, and gore, the language is a little strong, not too bad. Sex is limited, a little social drinking, a couple of prostitution-type implications in the scenes in Vietnam and Thailand. Tom Hiddleston's great. Samuel L. Jackson is over the top.
Yeah. Which we always like him.
Mm-hmm.
Like
John Goodman's really good. And the guy who was from Walking Dead and also the 24 Legacy is in this as a scientist. He does a great job. Brie Larson, Oscar winner, is there. It's a diverse supporting cast. And, of course, your themes are teamwork and courage and all that. Now, this is part reboot, part Apocalypse Now. I mean, let's be honest. The goriest and least approachable Kong to date. But Skull
really?
Island,
so it's over the top. In all respect.
Well, it's good.
Yeah, but it's good. But it's well done.
Skull Island has enough memorable creature battle scenes to make it fun, a little jumpy, good movie-going experience.
Yeah, the effects were brilliant.
You really need to see it on the big screen. They did a great job. There was no, like, when you saw Kong, his size, you know how in the old movies it was like one minute he's really big, and something's not so big in perspective, and this was good. This was really, really good with respect to that. Samuel L. Jackson's bloodthirsty, love of the smell of an apon in the morning kind of, you know, vengeance thing, and his fact that his name is Conrad, which goes back to the Apocalypse Now guy, Joseph Conrad.
Oh, sure.
There's a little bit of love. The aviator glasses, slow motion shots of helicopter rotator blades. It's all there. It's all there. So as I say, it's part Apocalypse Now homage. But except you don't have Marlon Brando's Colonel Kurtz living in the natives. Instead, it's John C. Reilly.
Yeah, and didn't see that coming.
Captain Marvel is also a Heart of Darkness Apocalypse Now name. Now, he's been stranded there. He gives a lot of levity, which is needed because it's a very intense, big-budget film with a lot of fight sequences. Very well executed, mind you, but gruesome. Everybody's there. Hiddleston seems a weird choice for his role, but he's good. He's very good. The supporting cast is fantastic. There's some terrible accents in there, but other than that, it's not bad. For high-stakes, jump-out-of-your-seat popcorn fare, this one will cover. Okay, this will do the trick. Don't expect quite the feel as you did for Kong, maybe in previous versions of the story. The Jessica Lange one, that was a little bit... That Jack Black one was a piece of duty. You know, you can go all the way back to the original Fay Wray's.
Yeah, they haven't been really that good, some of the reboots. So that's why I was a little leery, but I'm going to go see it now. You're saying see it while it's still on the big screen before it goes to the small?
See it on the big screen, and okay. I do give it 3 out of 5 Foxtails. So, it wasn't horrible, and it's definitely fun to watch. I got time for one more movie review for you, and that would be a new movie called Life. And
Life.
Yeah, there it is. Okay, we got Life. Lots of violence.
Lots of violence in life, just like real life.
No, it's about a, you know, it kind of reminds me of Alien a lot. But Therence, you need to know that Life is a sci-fi horror film. It's about a killer alien creature loose on board a satellite. Lots of violence, intense, scary stuff. Many characters are killed. One is torn apart from the inside.
So it's like Snakes on a Plane, but with an alien.
Yeah, a lab rat is destroyed gruesomely. A man's hands are smashed and broken horribly. Language is very strong.
I like what you tell us about, you know, what all the violence.
It's pretty intense for young kids.
Head will roll to the left and then up a hill.
You got Jake Gyllenhaal and Ryan Reynolds heading a cast. It's very diverse. You got some smart, realistic characters, but it was too intense for anyone, kid-wise, I would say under 15. Yeah, it doesn't really have anything that we haven't seen before when it goes sci-fi movies. But the execution, including the smooth camera work, tense editing, and good music, makes it kind of gripping. I mean, you stay with it. The camera glides along the corridors of the satellite like it's weightless. The crisp editing, the intense score, there's a lot of nervous suspense brought about from that. It's not as dark and shadowy as a similar movie, Alien, like I told you about, but the lights are used to an interesting effect. The characters are interesting. It's a familiar story, but I think you can enjoy it. Another 3 out of 5 Foxtails for Life. So there you have it.
Nice, I'll try that one out.
Yeah, I think you'll like that one too. Mm-hmm. Even if it is a familiar story, it's told well.
You're so cute, Melissa Fox. I love you.
Thank you.
It's Connections.
It's Connections. Yay, we'll be right back. Yeah, Life was well done.
So you like both of these a lot.
Have you been thinking about trying
Viagra? Good entertainment value.
Let me promise you the same results for less than $3 a pill.
So it's a variant of Alien, pretty much. For
Viagra, you're getting taken to the cleaners.
Con is a reboot and a results for less than $3.
We'll do the math for you. You say
Con is pretty good, man. Some of them say, oh, damn, the first time.
We'll give you 40 blue pills and 40 yellow pills.
You screamed out a couple times.
Really? Wow.
Yeah, we just heard his pitch.
Did you see it on the screen? Did you go out and see it?
No, we watched it on 55 inch, but that was
But that's close. That's good. That's nice. That's a movie. That's a movie experience.
Oh, yeah. That shit's awesome. And I'm going outside and smoke a little cigar while I have money. Why don't you check the Facebook? I don't know how you
did it. Yeah, sure. We have to
door in an unmarked Blackjack's gonna give you some Facebook love.
I'm gonna give you some Facebook love.
800-814-5031. That's
800-814-5031. Facebook love.
Do you know someone?
We love you guys.
Problem or drug addiction.
Facebook love.
What comes next?
It is a flower.
If you or someone close to you has a bad drinking
you heard that one from the other room.
Private health insurance. Free help may be available. Call a recovering addiction specialist now at the Detox and Treatment Helpline. They'll help you get clean and sober and give you
hello,
a
John, yeah. Hello, Missy. Thank you.
Treatment facility.
Hello,
it's
Todd.
Like a vacation, but a clean vacation. If you have private health
So on the commercial right now, they're talking about addiction.
Getting sober is just a free call away.
Hello, Dana. So hi, Carrie.
It's my addiction.
What's up, Andrew?
Confidential call now.
Hey, Joe boy.
Hey, Joe. We'll see you tomorrow night.
360-0314.
Tanya Schwarzenegger.
Schwarzenegger?
800-360-0314.
800-360-0314. That's not a very
what?
Schwarzenegger?
Yeah,
it was cool,
you know.
I think it was my brother being funny about
it. Your brother, which one? Hi, everybody. My name is Melissa Fox. I've been in radio for a really long time, and when people tell me how to do radio, it can kind of piss me off. I'm just saying.
Who tells you how to do radio?
I've heard it in the past. People think they know how things are done when they've only been in the business a couple of years. Trust me, you don't know shit until you've worked for 8 or 9 different radio stations in 30-some years. Just
seen it all. You've known it all.
Seen it, done it, met them all. So. What's up, Joe Boy? You coming in tomorrow night, right? We're going to feature you at 10:30?
YourComputerSolutions.net.
YourComputerSolutions.net. Folks, if you're listening, you need any help with computers, graphics, all kinds of websites, the man's the bomb. YourComputerSolutions.net. Tell them I sent you. Yeah, I thought that was an easy enough segment. It was good that you'd seen them.
Yeah, I gotta start. I gotta start watching them.
is the benefit that
we still made it about halfway through a dog's purpose. I just can't. I am trying.
Why is it? Why? Why? It's
just, the dog keeps dying
over and over and coming
back. Oh, this
back.
Sounds real heavy.
It is heavy. And then it's Josh Gad who's the dog's voice. My boy's name is Ethan. I know my name is Bailey.
Hi, Rochelle.
It's cute, but it's like...
Rochelle with the sexiest, one of the sexiest pictures on Facebook. Tanya with one of the... Also
I also
the
saw the Fate of the Furious.
Dana looking great. Oh, did you?
Yeah.
It beat the run in money already over Star Wars.
800-430-2120.
What?
That's
no?
800-430-2120.
It's all right. They were nice cars.
I'll tell you what, it made a ton of money.
Of course it did.
That
first weekend.
Yeah, true.
It'll get out.
Hey, sharing is caring. Please share the video. Thank you so much. This is Blackjack. I love you, baby. You're right there. This is Connections. Welcome back to Connections. We love Gabnet.net on live Monday nights. They do replays of our show from 1 a.m. to 3 a.m. Tuesday through Friday. Check us out. So we're talking about parenting and, you know, it's got its challenges, right?
Yeah, but we want to laugh a little bit.
Yeah. So now let's talk about some weird things that kids do. Because, you know, they do some weird things. Because they're experimenting, like you said, they're being curious, exploring their worlds. Right? So let's take a look at this here. On a camping trip, my son pretended a tree branch was his girlfriend. That wasn't strange enough. He later ran up to me while I was talking to a stranger and announced, I have to go bury my girlfriend now.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
Must have broke her.
That is pretty weird. Here's one from Kimberly. She said, you know what? The last year and a half, my three-year-old daughter's been playing with a plastic bloody severed foot. Takes it in the bathtub with her, pushes it around in the baby stroller.
I think it's time to take the foot away.
Oh,
I
no.
Think
if she wants to play with it, that's fine.
I think there's a little bit of something that you might turn into some kind of a hacker.
I'm really, yeah, this has my curiosity.
Yeah, why do you like the severed foot? What about the unsevered foot? That's not so good.
What about the whole body?
No. Well, you know what's funny is when I used to do the paper route, I would drive around Halloween, and you know there was always severed feet hanging out of like sewers and stuff.
Oh yeah, I used to have one in the back of my trunk. A severed foot used to
hang
out
off the back. So I mean, I get it. I'm with you, girl. I like that. That's a fun one. How about this one here? You got this one from
Kylie. Says I was picking up my son from kindergarten when I noticed that all the kids leaving his class had mustaches drawn on their face.
Uh-oh.
I then noticed my son sitting at a table looking sad with a huge handlebar mustache drawn on his face. Turns out, he got into trouble for starting the mustache club and drawing mustaches on his classmates with a marker, some by force.
Oh, no.
Oh, the some by force part.
Yeah.
Gotta take a look at that one.
Bullying a mustache.
My three-year-old son began crying inconsolably upon learning that worms don't have brains like humans and thus couldn't really be his friends.
Oh.
That was kind of cute.
Riley said, I walked in on my son. He was threatening his spaghetti. Said, I'm going to kill it. Not sure how that happened. There's a good one.
Noel. My son opened my underwear drawer and poured chocolate syrup all over everything inside.
Boy.
I never figured out his thinking process behind it. He even shut the drawer and put the syrup back in.
Oh my God. Yeah.
See, that's the weird part. That's when it gets a little weird. My daughter has given each of her hands a name and a long car ride. She plays with them even if the toys aren't around. They talk to each other and play games with each other. She recently brought her feet into the game. I used to have my hands talk puppet to puppet like that. I used to do something similar. But I never brought my feet into it.
Yeah, she brought in three extra friends there.
Sam said, this is funny. Said, my four-year-old, she's my oldest, and she had dark peach fuzz on the top of her ears and on her back when she was four. So one day I told her how hairy she was, you know, being silly. So she decided at that point that she was a werewolf. So for the next 2 months, she ran around barking and howling at the moon.
Wow, that's awesome.
I don't know if I would have ever said anything about her being hairy. You know, you get a complex.
Boy, what a complex.
Yeah.
You know.
This one's from Camille. I put my 1.5-year-old son on the counter next to a brand new Costco-sized margarine tub as I prepared some toast. I turned around for a second to look for my butter knife, and when I looked back, my son had both of his hands into the margarine and was rubbing it all over his face and body.
Because it feels good, right? It feels good to rub butter on your body, I think.
Yeah, it's like at that age, everything's new. Yeah. You know, so.
You get this one.
When our youngest was about 2, she'd go up behind my husband and sniff as if he farted and go, mmm. Oh.
there was some setup.
I never did that. Yeah, that had to be some kind of a shtick or something.
Ashley said, my 2-year-old likes to put his plate of food on the floor and eat it like our dog. He probably needs company while he's having a meal.
Elizabeth, I was in a bridal shop that had a short row of large mirrors, watching a friend try on a dress. Then my 3-year-old saw a sales lady go behind the row of mirrors and followed her. When I called for him, he reappeared with his hand over one eye, pretending to stagger and yelling, my eye! That lady took my eye. I was mortified. P.S. as I was.
That lady took my eye! My thumb! He took my thumb!
That lady probably ran remember out that? The store going, oh my God, he's blaming me for that. Oh,
I didn't touch him!
My now 5-year-old used to tell us, according to Rebecca, that we weren't her real parents. Her real parents were in the mountains, but bad people stole her. She wouldn't tell us how she'd miss them, and if she asked if we could take her back.
That didn't get in the wrong ears, you know?
Robin said, my 4-year-old asked if we could play that we're folding laundry at the beach.
Wow.
Why would...
Man, kids do say weird
stuff. Yeah, they do. They really do. Can we fold laundry at the beach? Probably because he wanted to go to the beach and
right.
Mama had household chores.
That's probably it.
It comes from Jody. My 4-year-old son recently started having an imaginary friend, Steve. Steve constantly needs his hand held, and when we go to the store across the road. This, of course, just looks like my son has his arm out. One day a person ran into Steve and hurt him so badly that my son had to break down in the middle of the aisle. He was still screaming to get Steve a doctor by calling 911 while I was talking to him out of the store.
Oh no, how embarrassing.
My 3-year-old loves ketchup, according to Sandra. She will eat pancakes with ketchup instead of syrup.
Yeah, that's gross.
Yeah, that's no good.
When my daughter was 3, she told Santa her name was Tyrone. After some weird looks from Santa and his helpers, I explained that she was a big fan of the Backyardigans, and that her real name is Libby.
Not Tyrone.
Yeah.
But she wants it to be Tyrone.
I actually watched Backyardigans a lot with Kate.
Yeah, it's fun stuff.
This one comes from Courtney. My 3-year-old daughter loves to walk around pretending she's a zombie in public.
Oh, Lord.
She groans with her arms completely stretched out and her head tilted to the side.
My 5-year-old son recently cupped his palm, farted in his hand, smiled at me, and then blew it in my face like a kiss. I keep getting the farting ones. That's funny.
It's the boys, man. It's always the boys.
Yeah, right. April said my nephew had chewing gum all of a sudden at a restaurant, so I asked him where he got it from, and he said, oh, under the table. That is so gross.
It's just like that scene they were showing an elf. That's what they put on this.
You get this one here, but I don't know that... Yeah, you get another one. We'll take this one for you.
My kid pulled his pants down and pooped on the floor at the grocery store while I was paying.
You had to go?
I guess when you got to go, you
were really getting the stupid ones.
Well, this is... You know, this hits home.
Yeah.
It says our 6-year-old son can't stop twerking. My 9-year-old son cannot stop twerking, and he's... really good at it too. It's scary.
You mean he twerks?
Yeah, he backs it up. You wouldn't believe how good he is.
Did you tell him it's not such a good idea maybe to back it up like that so much?
Well, I just told him
might
you
hurt
know,
something.
Stay in close quarters when you do this, you know, either in your room.
Yeah, don't start backing it up in third grade or whatever.
Yeah, you do this in school, you know, we're looking at big problems and then you know, then we're concerned.
You tell him that?
Oh, yeah.
That's fun.
That's fine. Tabitha said, I jumped ahead a little bit here. Tabitha said, my 4-year-old pooped in his bathtub, and when I explained he would now need a shower while I cleaned the bath, he insisted his poop was clean because it was in the tub. It's in a bath, it's clean.
I see his point.
My son has an imaginary friend named Owen, but all they do is fight. My son throws toys around the playroom, screams at Owen to stop and go away.
Now, you may
it's
have
really
a, you,
creepy.
You may want to have them Ghostbusters coming to your house or Ghost Hunter, man. That sounds a little creepy.
Lindsay, I was raking leaves in the yard when my 4-year-old son started picking up individual leaves and licking them. He said, this leaf came from Egypt, then licked another and proclaimed, this one's from Oregon.
Vanessa checking in here. She says, my 4-year-old son put a dried bean in his ear at preschool because they were making a craft with them, and he thought he was going to get in trouble once he realized it was stuck, so he didn't tell anyone. A month after school, it was over. He sneezed, and he said, there's a bean hurting my ear. And I said, what bean? One pediatrician visit and a referral to an ear, nose, and throat doctor. Later, the bean was safely removed. Yes, my child lived with a bean in his ear. Best guess, for 2.5 months.
Wow. Oh. You know, there's a song out there. You may have heard it. It's like a kid's song. Oh, I wish that all grown-ups had beans in their ears.
Beans in their ears.
Beans in their ears. Well, my nephew was actually listening to that song one day and trying to pour beans in his ears.
Oh boy.
No.
We are
really not that stuck.
There's actually a lot. I think it's a Pete Seeger song, actually.
What, Beans in the Ear?
Yeah.
He should be singing about
beans
that.
Beans in the Ear. Yeah, that
they should
it,
say,
beans
yeah.
in my ear, I think it's the beans in
the ear. No, beans up your nose is not any, great shakes either. Right?
No.
We were visiting my mother-in-law in the hospital, went to grab a bite to eat in the cafeteria. My 3-year-old son, for absolutely no reason, suddenly stopped eating, looked up at a nurse walking by, and ran his finger across his throat. Like you're getting your head chopped off. Then he smiled and went back to eating like nothing had happened.
That's the one.
Oh, gosh.
I never heard this song in my entire life. I didn't even think it was real.
My mommy said not to put beans in my ears. Beans in my ears. Why not?
And I always thought the end of that song was so brilliant because, that it's all about that. And then at the end, it's, I think that all grown-ups have. And I'm like, yeah, they do,
Have beans in their ears?
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah, they never played this one in Brooklyn. We never got the beans in the ears song.
Oh, this is my jam back in about 1979.
Right. Yeah, it's a Pete Seeger tune, but that was the Serendipity Singers right there.
Good old Pete Seeger, rest in peace.
Hi, man.
He lived a long time.
Yeah, he's a good funny guy.
Parents are going to share the weirdest things their child has done.
Mm-hmm.
We did that. We're got Band of Skulls coming up, though.
You goofball. And we've got the news thing, but first, we must play some music to go to a break and support our sponsor, Seminole Harley-Davidson, yourcomputersolutions.net. StagesOfLife.net. Buy you some Stud Mix. We'll love
it. Oh, Stud Mix. StagesOfLife.net. Dr. Dave is with us this week, too, Wednesday night.
Yeah,
so.
Nunez Productions. Joseph Boy is going to be with us from yourcomputersolutions.net tomorrow night, along with
Donna Moore is on tomorrow night, 11:15. Also, I want to thank our friends at DB Trucking, great trucking company. If you want, they truck gas around. We were just talking about gas in that last segment, so it was very good. Very apropos, as they say.
That's true.
Follow us on Instagram. We are on Instagram at ConnectionsFM, and we will follow you back, of course, because that's what we do. I remember this one.
It's so funny.
I remember this one.
So funny because that song and this song was both on a thing called Dumb Days, and that's what we own. That's where I heard all these weird songs.
Rest in peace.
Yep. This is Connections. Chuck Berry,
Connections. But he had that surprise hit in the early 70s with My Dangling, because he kind of went away. Yeah, one more hit. My Dangling.
Hey, Richard, I don't know if you're... Hey, Brady. Richard, I don't know if you're there yet, but if you are, happy birthday.
Hi, Dad.
To apply for available local CDL truck driving opportunities, please visit dbtrucking.com. That's dbtrucking.com.
Yeah, I love it.
Hey, Brad.
Sister-in-law, her...
945 is good.
Last name is Kurt, so I always said she should have named it. her child, Richard.
Mm-hmm. One of my favorites.
There, girl.
Hi.
The floodgates. Band of Skulls.
Visit newyearsproductions.com today to get a free quote on your project. That's NUNEC
Productions.com. Keeping your lady happy, emergency hotline. Can you see any better? They only help me see far away. So, like, you're blurry now. But if I take them off, you're fine. But then when I try to look at you from back there, I can't see you. I have to put on my glasses. But I'm trying to make it like a Clark Kent. And then not. We'll see if it works. Be right back. Blackjack's Artist of the Week. You're going to like this one.
Yeah, this one looks good. Four studio albums.
Yeah, they're a fun group. It's man and a woman. I don't know if they're family or not, but they do really good stuff together.
Yeah, it's a power trio. Some of the Harley
invites you to
their April riding season.
So they're married?
Stopping now,
I'm not sure.
Hey, Steve Cantina. Wait. Steve Cantina just checked me. I called him. I don't remember that. Plus, get your best rates on high-quality free-inspected motorcycles before they're gone. We'll even pay off your trip. So, hey, Melissa. First time hearing the show. I did get a lot. It was nice to hear John Frank, too. I haven't heard from him in a while. Keep it up. Sheila and the Saturday Bar fly on Sunday. Both shows start at noon. Visit
7oHarley.com for more info. See you there. My man's ED is destroyed. Yeah, he was really good. I was actually pleasantly surprised when I went to his site to hear his music.
John, yeah. Yeah, it's got some soul.
I'm rather picky.
Estradiol and DHT, testosterone levels go up, estrogen levels go down, and things improve in your bedroom.
It takes a couple of weeks to get things going, but now my man's back better than ever.
StudMix is an intelligent approach giving you that push that most men need.
Go to stagesoflife.net and try StudMix now.
StudMix.
The following message is brought to you by...
We love StudMix. Your first choice. Why do you think I am who I am? Why do you think porn star Pete is who he is? You can save
money. StudMix. Makes you a little bit more confident. Do you think you're paying too much
for your current health insurance? That's one confident man right there. You see that smoldering sex appeal that porn star Pete has?
No fear, no shame.
Call us. We're Health Markets.
Definitely no shame.
No shame, always a little fear, because fear keeps you strong, right? Keeps you vibrant.
Yes.
If you're just fat and happy, who wants to hear that? You got to be hungry, baby. A little bit of blackjack, one-on-one.
That's
Alrighty. Well, you know what?
What?
I'm gonna let you get away with it this time.
That's good. Watching Happy Gilmore on
Netflix. Did you take my eyeliner? No. Netflix. It just might bring everyone together. Start your free trial at Netflix.com.
That was my fault. Was talking. Sorry. 2, 1.
She's out of control! Out of control! Woo!
Time again.
connections.
Everybody do the blackjack. Everybody do the blackjack.
That's another one. I sure hope he's...
Band of Skulls. Love these guys out of England. This is a really good choice. It's a power trio consisting of Russell Marsden, who does the guitar and vocals, Emma Richardson, bass and vocals, and Matt Hayward, drums. I like these British bands because you can usually pronounce their names pretty well. They're from Southampton. They formed after meeting in college, and Marsden and Hayward have been friends since school. So that answers the question earlier, Porn Star Pete. No, they are not married. Band of Skulls released 4 albums, their most recent being By Default. Came out May of last year. And, of course, when the group first started, they played at nightclubs in the Greater London area, recorded some demos under the name Fleeing New York, which I think I heard of, before they changed it to Band of Skulls in 08. Band's original demos were recorded in Hayward's father's shed studio. So without further ado, Band of Skulls. On Connections, this is Sweet and Sour. Kind of psychedelic, right? Sweet Sour, Band of Skulls. Funky, like psychedelic funk.
And I just flip right out of my head. It's all good. Yeah, what's
kind of a little bit of. I don't know. It almost felt like it had a little bit of like.
Was doing some Lenny Kravitz in there.
Yeah, Kravitz, or even earlier Hendrix. Some Hendrix riffs. They almost sounded like there was.
Yeah, that's pretty good stuff.
We'll hear more about them this week. That's our artist of the week. And now it's time for the news thing.
What was their name again, please?
Band of Skulls. So we had Skull Island, and then we had Band of Skulls, and now we're doing the Skull thing with Melissa Fock. We changed the name.
It's the news thing. It's not the Skull thing. So, you know, we talked about a little earlier, Coachella over the weekend.
Coachella.
Somebody managed to steal, I mean, it's just one guy, stole over 100 cell phones.
It was Drake.
Was it the guy who wanted to...
What do you mean? Like, people's cell phones, they'd lay them out, or they'd pickpocket, or...
I don't know if they were all stuck in one place, or what, but, yeah, over 100 cell phones were stolen by maybe a prolific pickpocket. I don't know.
Wow.
But I do, I want to find out, I want to know more. Once again...
What can you do with a cell phone if it's locked, though? Well, you just part it out, or is that what you do? I mean, what's the point of having a cell phone? Everybody's got the security on them, right, so...
I think people know how
to break them.
Yeah, how to get through.
Yeah, you can break, you can bust them in or unlock them or whatever. A man was arrested in L.A. He allegedly fed an unknowing co-worker THC-laced chocolate.
Uh-oh.
The victim ended up being unable to finish her shift. You know, it's such a terrible thing to do on an unwilling victim and such a waste of a good edible.
She don't know how to hold day chocolate.
I say. Good stuff. The rest of the day just floated by, but she didn't get a lot done. Yeah. So we have a fight that broke out at Walmart, also in L.A., by the way. And a large crowd showed up, not to try and break it up, of course, but to get video of it. Now, I'm not even surprised anymore. They don't help. One guy appears to be trying to break up the combatants, but... he ends up getting knocked unconscious when another bystander wades in and just cold cocks him. Where was store security? And why doesn't Walmart supply better security anyway? I mean, what the heck?
I guess they don't want to pay for it, maybe.
Mm, guess.
It's not in their budget.
You know that lady, the oldest lady in the world, the Jamaican woman, 117 years old, finally passed away.
Yeah.
And they've been asking her for years what her secret was. I mean, she was spry, if you all the way up to the end. She said her secret was no rum, beer.
No rum, beer.
Really, I heard another one that was way up there in age.
117, she was Italian. I think Italian and Jamaican died around the same time.
And this one said her secret was port wine.
Port wine.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So is customer service dead? Is it dead?
Pretty much.
It's pretty dead.
I mean, if you consider United or even Wells Fargo, people aggressively treat like their customers like the enemy, you know? And you can say you won't use them again, but is it our fault? Is it our fault?
We are the companies we make.
It's our fault. I knew it.
It's not my fault. I'm Blackjack. I'll see you tomorrow night at 10.
Hey, I'm Melissa Fox. Thanks for listening. Love you, mean it.
Porn star Pete.
Good job, everybody.
Nice show. Good job.
We try not to say things that are not
so disgusting. It's so mellow now. It's like we come in and
see it's mellow. Yeah, there's no stress. It's nice.
Isn't it nice?
We're doing a radio show.
It's good to have you here.
Thank you. Much love to you as well.
Thanks, guys. We enjoyed it.
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow, guys.